National Guard says it has a problem at a LaMoure County dam under control. The Guard says sandbags, riprap, and rock were used to slow down erosion at Lake LaMoure. Nearly 300 one-ton sandbags have been placed at the site. Crews have also built a secondary dike to try to redirect the flow of the water. The biggest threat is to area roads and farms, which have already been evacuated.
Down the road a ways, the cows are calling frantically from Jace Mitchell's grandpa's yard. The family's checking to see if their tractor makes it through, as well as the National Guard does.
Barely gets through the water.
To give you an idea of just how deep that water is, when they drove the payloader and they say the water came to the top of the tires, I would be in it up to my neck. And with those currents, it's not a good idea.
Takes you wherever it wants to go.
In spite of the struggle,
damn, I wonder what I'm all done.
They're finding a way to make it through by keeping in mind it's the neighbors.
It's kind of fun.
Not the real estate that makes a neighborhood great.
It's just an overwhelming feeling, like you can't ever repay them back.
Emily Welker, Valley News.
Cheyenne Valley City's temporary sewer system is now complete. We showed you that being built yesterday. It's still maxed out, though, so residents have to use portable toilets for the time being. And the temporary system was built after a major failure on Friday. They've been trying to clear out backups in the sewer system since then. Residents are getting clean drinking water through the faucet, though. They just can't dump anything down the drain.
Flood reminders in many neighborhoods are on their way out.
Good evening, everyone. Thanks for tuning in tonight. Crews start removing clay dikes in many Fargo neighborhoods tomorrow morning.
Valley News team's Lisa Bedeau is live in a South Fargo development that will be one of the first to see those clay dikes cleared out. Lisa?
Yeah, well, as you can imagine, a lot of people are ready to get back to normal, and these large clay dikes need to go for that to happen. The good news is the process will get underway tomorrow. Well, the city has broken down removal areas into three sections. Dikes will be taken down along South University Drive and Edgewood's Entry Road first. Then crews will start removing all contingency dikes. Clay dikes in backs of homes are up next. And finally, dikes on public property off streets, off of streets right-of-ways as well. And cleanup of the HESCO bags will start tomorrow as well. Contingency areas first, then private properties. And as far as Moorhead, work on the removing clay dikes should also happen this weekend. Bids should be given out on Friday. So just a couple days away for Moorhead residents.
Two reasons to be happy. They're going and they weren't needed.
Right, exactly.
Thanks, Lisa.
Well, he told us earlier this week he didn't want to hold a special election for a sales tax hike.
But Fargo Mayor Dennis Wallacher now says it is the most painless way to put money toward permanent flood protection. Speaking at City Hall today, Wallacher explained the estimated price tag of getting permanent flood protection for the city at nearly $1 billion. He says Fargo would be responsible for footing about $200 million of that bill. The mayor says a half-cent sales tax increase for the next 20 years would cover that. Now, city leaders are eyeing Tuesday, June 30th as the special election day. The vote would require 60% approval. The tax would go into effect January of 2010. The city commission is expecting to approve the resolution later this month.
Well, we hope things are settled down in Valley City soon, but in the meantime, we're kind of getting ready for a celebration of sorts to honor the hard work done during this flood of 2009.
Valley News Live, KFGO Radio, and the rest of Radio Fargo-Moorhead are teaming up with the Fargo Marathon for a Will Over Water party next month.
Race director Mark Knutson's opening up the traditional post-marathon celebration May 9th to everyone in the Valley and beyond who helped battle high water. The day's race activities will wrap up around 3, and the Dome will reopen at 6 for an after-the-flood fight celebration. I believe there will be some bands. Is it Johnny Holm and 32 Below?
Yep, and there's food and drinks.
Until it runs out.
Until it runs out, which is the way you want it at a party.
Yeah, that's true.